Get more from your laser by going out of focus. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about focusing onto kisscutting, also known as scoring. But more importantly, is how to take it to the next level, because most scoring, or kisscutting, is done with just one line width. However, what if I told you, by just unfocusing your laser, you can get different line widths on the same job. Additionally, depending on the speed of your laser, scoring can be much faster. Of course, it is very dependent on the artwork. So for instance, with me, which I have quite a slow engraving laser, which is the Glowforge, I can do something like this size, but it would take me around 3 hours. But with kisscutting, this only took me 20 minutes. Having said that, I will be focusing mainly on Glowforge users here, but I will be giving all the information needed so you can do this on any laser cutter, because I have done this on a wide range of other laser cutting machines and the steps are practically the same. So to start with, what we need to do is a kiss cutting guide. Now I'm not going to be showing you how to get the kiss cutting settings because quite frankly, you just get the cut settings of your material and you put down the power. It's as simple as that. You're trying to just kiss cut the top of the material to leave a mark or a score line. Now, when it comes to the kiss cutting guide, we've got to keep some things in mind. What this is no offset from the material or from the bed. It depends how you want to do this. I like to do this from the bed and then go upwards. And then from there, I'm able to just take it away. More than anything, that's because of my Glowforge, but I will explain this now. So this material is 3 millimeters. So you'll see that if we go to here, all these first ones are exactly the same. Then between 3 and 6, they increase in size. And because this is a Glowforge, I can only go up to 6 millimeter thick material. So from 6 millimeters onwards, the line thickness stays the same. However, if your laser can take much thicker material with a moving bed or something along those lines, or where you're able to manually focus it, you'll also see that you'll be able to set up a manual focus point, move down the bed so you can change the Z-axis of your bed, which is also the equivalent of unfocusing your laser. The widest I've been able to get a kiss cut line is about a centimeter. Now you've got to be very careful with that because at that point you're going to also have to increase the power and it will be a specific setting for that amount of offset. So feel free to download this file, it's down in the description. And of course I want to show you how I set this up for my Glowforge. And I know for those that don't have a Glowforge, you'll see that it's pretty much the same steps. You might have to do a little Googling to find out how to do your Z offset or your lens defocusing for your specific machine. But let's go and show you how I've done mine. So this here is the testing file that I have to see all the widths that I have available on each material that I use. Of course, this is going to be different for a material such as paper that will literally be a difference as soon as I go up to 1, to a material that starts at 3 millimeters high, and then technically that's 1 millimeter offset, 2 and 3 millimeters of offset. So as it's already set up, let me just show you quickly. So this one, the top one, is just an engraving. Then I've ordered all of these, so it just goes along this. Now I already have a setting, which is my birch kiss cut. And of course, this is 0, so it has no offset at all. However, then we go here to the first one, and you'll see I have this set to 1 millimeter. Then I've got this set here to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Now, obviously, if you're not using a Glowforge, this is going to be completely different. And you're going to have to look for something called a Z offset or a focal offset. I'm pretty sure you'll be able to find this within your laser cutting operation or software. The key aspect here is all of these are their own colors as you have it in the download, as is to set the Z height or the focus length to each one so that you can then be informed by your little test here. Once you have your offset or defocusing little chart here, you'll be able to see the type of results that you can get in. So for me, because I'm on the Glowforge, you'll see that this here up to 3, it doesn't change. That's because the Glowforge does all its calculations from the bed upwards. So if I were to actually lower this down to the bed level, I would have a much greater range of lines to choose from. Now, once you have a range of lines to choose from, here's where you can get artistic and really start to create things as you want them, with thin lines and thick lines all in one pass. So for instance, I've done this with this contouring of a map. I will have another video that will be linked down in the description that I'll be making that I'll show you how to make this both in Blender and out of Blender. And now by using our little chart that we've just got there, I know the settings that I'm going to be using within my contour lines. So as you see, I've got three things here. I have my fine lines, my thick lines, and my outside cut. My fine lines are going to be done right here with the automatic focus point, so zero offset. And then my larger lines are going to be at my maximum offset, which is at 6 millimeters. And then I just have a normal cutting right there. So now with this cutting, of course, I've kept this very simple. This only has two different lines, which is the default line and my thickest line. But you can get a lot more complicated. And this here is the end result. As you can see, it's very obvious the thin and thick lines, which are the contour references for the map. Additionally, with this mandala here, you can see that I've done both thick and thin lines all in one pass. And what something really interesting that you can do is if you put a whole bunch of thick lines together, it turns out to a type of engraving. In fact, if you really wanted, you can measure how thick your new Kisscut line is and then create Kisscut engraving. So manually setting up an engraving path. I've got another future video where I'll be showing you some really cool things that you can do when you take that to its full potential. And with that all said, it's that easy to unlock your new superpower, which is defocused or offset Kisscut lines. I really do mean it that you're going to find a whole bunch of uses for this because it is so much quicker than engraving. I know that for me, it was a game changer when I really took it into practice. Now, a huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are awesome and it means the world to me. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here and think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord. It's down in the description. Feel free to join it and show me what you're making. Thank you for watching. Keep making and let the quest continue.